Tonight on Newsmax Now, the Cohen aftermath. President Trump's approval rating is up as rumors of his impeachment continue to swirl. Meanwhile, National Enquirer publisher American Media admits to cutting a deal with then-candidate Trump to kill negative stories. What does this mean for the president and the Russia investigation? Plus, we are just over a week away from the looming government shutdown. What does this mean and what actually will close and how will it affect you? We'll go in depth on that. And taxing your text, California's new idea to help connect its residents. All that and much more tonight on Newsmax Now. Welcome to Newsmax Now. I'm John Bachman. We begin tonight with the admission coming out of American Media, Inc., the publishing giant that worked with President Trump during his campaign to apparently kill negative stories about the candidate, specifically stories about Trump's relationships with women like Stormy Daniels and former Playboy model Karen McDougal. Federal prosecutors in New York say they've reached a non-prosecution agreement with AMI, where Trump's friend David Pecker is the chairman and CEO. The deal shows that New York investigators are looking further into possible campaign finance violations and who in Trump's team was exactly involved. So what does AMI's cooperation mean for Trump and the Russia investigation? Joining us tonight to discuss this, former federal prosecutor Larry Klayman, and also with us from our, who will be joining us throughout the show on our panel tonight, is Heather Hansen. She's a trial attorney and partner at O'Brien and Ryan. Heather, Larry, thanks for being here. All right, we're going to go to Larry first. First question, Larry, how concerned should President Trump be about the cooperation agreement between American Media and David Pecker? I'm sorry, I'm president and the federal prosecutors. All right, I think we're having some trouble getting everybody connected here. We're going to move on to our next story. And we're talking about Michael Cohen here, of course. And this was the big news yesterday. President Trump's former personal attorney and so-called fixer was sentenced yesterday to 3 years in prison, plus hundreds of thousands of dollars in forfeiture and restitution and fines for those criminal charges that include tax evasion, lying to Congress, and arranging hush money payments to women on behalf of President Trump. Now, Cohen argued that his blind loyalty to Trump made him feel a duty to cover up the president's, quote, dirty deeds. Well, today, President Trump broke his silence about Michael Cohen on Twitter. Quote, I never directed Michael Cohen to break the law. He was a lawyer and he was supposed to know the law. All right, now I believe we have Heather Hansen with us. Heather, great to talk to you.
It's good to be here.
All right, a couple questions. So we're looking at this, you know, the situation with what we learned about Michael Cohen yesterday, the American media fallout. First, I want to ask you about American media. And if you were representing President Trump or you were working on his legal team, how concerned would you be about this cooperation agreement?
Quite concerned, John, because it is clear that this company and the head of this company has a lot of information. He's good friends with Donald Trump, but most importantly, because the two stories go together. This new information about AMI corroborates the information that we know about Cohen, and that's the thing that we look for in these types of cases is corroboration. So the more that there's corroboration between one story and the next, the more I'd be concerned if I was on a president's team.
Now, the legality of this, you know, President Trump, he was a candidate back then. A lot of his defenders say, what's the big deal? You know, he was doing this to make sure his family was protected. They didn't find out about it. But what if President Trump did actually pay for this arrangement? Is there anything illegal about doing that?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. And you make a very good point. There's a difference. We looked at John Edwards, and John Edwards faced a similar case and was arguing that it was simply to protect his family. And you see some of the things that the president has tweeted that it seems to be that he's trying to set up an argument that it's the same thing. However, what we've seen from Mueller's office seems to say that this was explicitly made in order to affect the campaign. And that's going to be a major point if this case actually were to go forward against the president. Because to your point, if he says that it was simply to protect Melania, that may be a good defense. But it seems pretty clear that Mueller believes that there is enough evidence to say that this was done to affect the campaign. And that's going to be a problem.
All right, well, let's welcome in Larry Klayman, former federal prosecutor. Larry, Heather says this is going to be a problem for President Trump. Do you agree? Could there be a big legal problem here? And how concerned would you be if you were representing President Trump about this cooperation agreement between AMI and the federal prosecutors?
I don't know, Heather. I'm sure she's a nice person, John, but she probably wishes there will be a problem. I don't believe the campaign finance issue is a big issue at all. In fact, Hillary Clinton back in the late 90s, we uncovered that she took $2 million of campaign contributions, hard money, through a Hollywood tribute to Bill Clinton for pay for her Senate campaign. Nothing happened to her. Should have, but it didn't. This is a lot about nothing, but really the big issue on the horizon here is the so-called interim report of Robert Mueller, which is going to be so scathing and it's going to be so negative towards the president and smear him that it's going to trigger impeachment, and we're going to get into a proceeding in the House of Representatives and then a trial in the Senate. So I think that's the big risk, not this campaign finance thing. It's not a big deal.
Heather, do you feel the same way, that once this report finally does come out from Robert Mueller, there'll be so much pressure to move forward with impeachment?
It's going to be a political question, John. I think it's going to be more political than legal. You're going to have to see whether or not the Democrats want to take the risk of shutting down the government, going through all the machinations of trying for impeachment, knowing full well that the Senate has to approve that, and the chances of the Senate actually doing that are slim to none. I think that the Democrats have to think long and hard whether they want to take the high road and be able to say that we're not going to waste the time and the money to pursue impeachment and wait to see what happens once President Trump's time is over and whether or not he's criminally charged for not only we've got two different issues here, as your other guest points out.
Right.
You've got so there's a lot there. And the question's going to be a political one, whether to pursue impeachment.
Well, you know,
so based on your answer right there, Heather, and hold on one second, Larry, because I want to read into this. Heather, you are of the belief that a sitting president cannot be indicted, right?
I am.
All right. All right, Larry, go ahead. I'm sorry.
When was the last time that Nancy Pelosi, Adam Schiff, Gerald Nadler and company took the high road? I mean, give me a break.
It's a problem, really, with all members of Congress. And even though, Larry, they have that lesson from the Clinton impeachment, Republicans learned a valuable lesson there. I don't think Democrats are going to learn from that, from the Republicans' problems with the impeachment.
You know, I may differ with you on that, because it was the Clinton impeachment, even though it didn't succeed in the Senate, because it was basically deep sixed by Senate Republicans there who really didn't make an effort to convict him. It wounded Clinton enough that it hurt Al Gore. I believe that's what prevented Al Gore from winning.
That's a good point.
It
also came at the very end of President Clinton's presidency, so it's a different, kind of a different set of circumstances. I think a lot of people would say, well, he's leaving office, it's 1999. President Trump has another term ahead of him. Heather, what do you think about Larry's assessment?
I think you make a very good point, John. I think 2019 is going to be a very difficult year for the president. We just saw, just minutes before I came here, there's now some question about inauguration monies and what's happened with those monies. I think that these types of things are going to keep coming up, and as more and more of the dominoes continue to fall, even if there's no criminal pursuit of anything right now, and even if they don't pursue impeachment, this is going to be a difficult year for the president. He's got Democrats in the House now. I think that all in all, we're going to see a lot less good work coming out of our government.
Well, that's true. Yeah, I agree with that. But John, this president's a fighter, okay? He likes the fight. I like the fight. And I'll tell you something. That's the only way you're going to survive in today's world. So don't think the Democrats are going to be able to roll over the president. But the first thing he should do is get him some new lawyers who have let him get dragged.
Exactly what I was going to add. Well, I know you're not a big fan of Rudy Giuliani and President Trump's legal team, Larry, but what about his chief of staff? He doesn't have a chief of staff right now. And there are a lot of questions about the personnel inside the White House. Are you concerned that the president, I know you don't like his legal team, but separate and apart from that he has enough support around him to protect him from this subpoena cannon that we hear so much about?
I am concerned about that. I mean, from what I read, he doesn't really have a staff in the White House counsel's office to any degree. And there are rumors, that Newt Gingrich may be the chief of staff. I would hope. I mean, Newt's not perfect, but I think he'd be pretty good at that job, and it would be wise to bring him in.
But John,
he does have experience.
Part of the problem is that no one stays. This constant turnover, for whatever reason, I don't pretend to know why this happens, but there seems to be one consistent factor. And this constant turnover is another problem. I mean, it would be great for the president if he had a loyal group of people surrounding and supporting him, but we see that that's just not the case. There's no consistency there.
I also wanted to ask you about this too, guys. Larry, one more thing I want to get in before we have to go to commercial break here and say goodbye to you, unfortunately, is, we take a look at all this stuff, all these developments recently. A lot of folks say this is bad news for President Trump, but you look at his approval rating. Fox News has President Trump's approval rating at 46%, down just 1 point from October, despite all these rumors and these new reports here. There are also several reports now that Trump seems worried about the impeachment. I don't know about that, but the approval rating 46%, considering everything we're hearing so far. Real quickly, Heather, first to you, then to you, Larry. What's your reaction to that?
I mean, listen, I think that people want to have, it's the economy. And as long as there are jobs and as long as people feel as though the economy is improving, his approval rate will stay right around there. If that changes, John, in light of everything else that's going on, it will be a real problem for the president.
Larry?
Well, that may be the case, but the fact is he's doing a good job. And he's one president, I got to tell you, in my lifetime, who actually says what he thinks. The rest of them have just lied to the American people. I don't care if there's small little lies here or there, but the major issues, this president tells the truth. He tells the truth about corrupt judges. He tells the truth about corrupt politicians. He tells the truth about what's happening on our border. And the American people appreciate that. And the American people are not people that went to Harvard and Yale. They're people in the streets that know what the facts of life are all about.
Well, there, you know, we could have a long show about the definition of a lie when it comes to politics in Washington, D.C. in 2018. But Heather brings up a great point, too, about the economy. That could be a big factor in all this as well. Larry, Heather, great to see you. Heather's going to stick around with us. More to come here.